Everyone, welcome to my another new video. Now today's topic I will discuss about our I-beam painting and I-beam installation. Also I will discuss about our crane fitting. That means we have two types of crane. Another one is hoist crane and another one is monorail crane. For fitting monorail crane or hoist crane, at first we need fitting our I-beam installation. That's why we need I-beam fabrication, I-beam painting, then we can fit our crane, we can start our crane work. Now I will show. Already I can see in front of my camera here also I have engineer Mr. Junaid. He is also expert of I-beam engineer, and this side also I have our senior foreman Mr. Hakim Bhai. He is also I-beam working person, and this side all guys are working in our I-beam. Actually this team is our I-beam team. They are actually special and specialist for our I-beam working. Now I will show how we will work in our I-beam working. Mr. Junaid will say now what types of chemical or what types of paint we will use in our I-beam installation.
In I-beam work, we need to paint work. There is two types of first type is the epoxy primer, then the final coat is the epoxy final coat. Then before that we need to primer. The primer we use the brand name is Nippon Paint. Here is the here's the look here. The name of the this is our this okay. is the, our Nippon primer. And this is the hardener. We know hardener is just make the liquid dry up to attach the surface. And if we paint got the hardened, then we use some thinner which liquefied the our solid paint work. Then after the coating this color, the gray color is our primer color. Primer color is set after 24 hours, it makes dry up. Then we use our final coat, the yellow amber. When we mix the yellow amber, look here, there is some yellow amber here. Before preparation of our yellow amber, we need to put again hardener. There is the percentage is 80-20%. Where 80% is the our yellow amber and 20% our is the hardener. The same purpose, hardener is always same, which makes the paint is must dry up as soon as possible. When it gets much harder, when this roller, when coating roller not run, then we use our thinner to make the roll and roll again. And this also took 1 hour. Also, I would like to add one more thing that here our primer, there is a hardener ratio and coat ratio is 50-50. Whereas our final coat, the ratio is our 80-20. Where 80 is our yellow amber and 20% is the our hardener. This is our paint work, and the paint work is ongoing. Look here, over there, this is our primer coat. This is our gray color. Then we use our final color, this will be our yellow amber.
Thank you, Mr. Junaid. And now I can give you a summary. Actually, Mr. Junaid already described all things about our I-beam paint and I-beam installation about like this. Now I will give a summary here. Now
preparation for I-beam.
Now I will give a summary preparation for I-beam. Now I will give a summary here. That's why this is our prime. We can see this is our main coating. That means this is our main paint, amber yellow. And for the we will mix here hardener. This is our hardener bottle. We will mix hardener in this our main paint for color attach in our I-beam. And then this is our primer. This is our primer, and this is our primer bottle, and this side also this is our hardener bottle. That means we will mix 50% hardener and 50% primer. We will mix, then we will give first coat, and this is 80-20% our main coating amber yellow and hardener. Then we will give two coat of amber yellow. Then we will get and we will reach our required thickness 25 micron. If we will get trouble in our work, that means when our coating or our paint will be hard, then we can use thinner here. And this side also we can see this is our amber yellow paint. Okay, almost I have finished my job, and this side we can see our guys already they are working in I-beam painting. Actually our procedure is, at first we will clean our I-beam, and after if any dust or any concrete rough surface, then at first we clean. After cleaning this one, then we will use our cap brush. Where is cap brush? And after rough concrete surface removing, then we will give our cap brushing. That means by this brushing we will remove any dust or anything we can remove by this cap brush. Okay, iron rust actually we can remove by this cap brush. After removing iron rust, then we will clean our I-beam surface by jute, something like that. Then after cleaning this one, this is our jute, and by this jute we will clean our iron surface or I-beam surface. Then we will start our first coat primer. Okay, after giving primer, then after giving primer coat, then after 24 hours we will give here our main coat, and we will give here two times main coat, because that's why actually our summer is, at first we will give primer coat, then we will give again main seal coat, then again we will give a main seal coat. That means we will do three times work in our I-beam paint. Okay guys, today's topic was I-beam painting and I-beam fabrication. Okay, thank you everyone.